say little dead meme. Hey everybody, welcome back. Welcome to the Snark Tank Podcast. It's me, Chris Reagan, and I'm joined as always by some black eye and Tom Sweet. Why are you rocking like an animal?
Nervous, dude. I'm hella nervous.
I've never been
dude.
On camera before. This is
I don't usually do this when people are recording, you know?
It is a special day. We've got video now. We've got video. We're trying this out. Hopefully this goes well. I understand that there's been a decent, I've gotten a lot of messages about concerns based on like other shows that have gone video from audio, that it's like unlistenable to audio listeners because like it just becomes like, hey, you know, look at this thing that's on video, and if you're listening on audio, fuck you. So we're very conscious of that. I don't care though, so deal with it.
Yeah, and we're not a clip show either, so it's not gonna be drastic or something.
Yeah, like, we're not juggling shit, you know? Like, we're not, like, we're not doing, like, crazy stunts that you guys are gonna have to tune into the video to see.
You guys
by the way, check
anything.
Out my shirt. My shirt
That's
is
cool.
so...
Look
you
at,
got, you
my,
got,
my shirt's kind of fire, too.
Oh my gosh.
You guys see my shirt?
Slasher? Listeners? It's pretty lit, honestly. Yours is better than mine, but mine is pretty lit too. Slasher.
Okay,
and
so
he's got
this,
a skateboard.
I wanna fuck you in the ass, motherfucker.
Okay, suck so this is the exact kind of thing that won't be happening. but anyway, before we get too deep into today's very special post-election episode, I wanted to let everybody know about a big change coming to the podcast. We announced this on Patreon and on Twitter. So just check those for more in-depth details. But we've decided to kind of change the days that the podcasts go live. Instead of Mondays on Patreon and Thursdays on free feeds, we'll be posting one day later, so Tuesdays on Patreon and Fridays on free feeds. There's a bunch of reasons why, and you can see that in the free Patreon update that is on the Patreon. If you go to patreon.com/snarktank, you can read that and keep up to date with everything that's going on. We missed last week, and that is also detailed in that post as well. We're also going to be doing some solo episodes. We promised this a couple months ago, so we're going to be doing that. The first one I'm going to handle because I got so many like weird specific Halo questions that I don't want to fucking put Derek through. So we're just going to get that done. That'll be out soon, but there's more details on the Patreon, so if you want to check that out, you can. And with that housekeeping done, where are we at now? We're in Joe Biden's America now.
We are, man.
Potentially. Yeah. Potentially.
Not so fast.
Nah, dog.
Trump has claimed multiple times that he won.
That's true, yeah.
He has. He won't give up, man. For it. He won't give up, bro.
I admire the tenacity.
Yeah,
it really is just fascinating to watch, because initially, like, I thought, like, okay, this might go somewhere, and then like the Electoral College votes just shot the fuck up, and I was like, oh, okay, well, I don't even think a recount will help. But
he didn't just kind of lose; he lost. He got whooped. Idea of someone like
he didn't get landslided, but he definitely like. He lost by a good margin.
He lost by a good margin.
Yeah, he lost.
He didn't win the fight,
I would say. No, it wasn't.
Yeah.
It has been wild seeing, you know, just the Twitter shit is like on point. I'm making a video right now about
it's
like
good.
the reaction to the election, and it's just I keep having to add shit, like it just keeps coming. It's wild.
You're going to have that shit till January, bro.
I have so much stuff collected, I decided to actually forego all the rest of it. Because I already put out like a salty aftermath video, which a lot of the... Since I was never so hostile towards Trump, just other than like say when he was missile striking Syria and shit, stuff like that.
Yeah.
I wasn't really like constantly being, oh, he's this, he's that, because I really didn't care. So then I made that video just making fun of everybody being absolutely ridiculous and be like, yeah, he won, everything's fraud, blah, 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 and stuff. And people were so angry. People, I thought, I'm like, come on, guys. I've been this radical centrist guy, this quote unquote, like, just this fucking guy the entire time. And then in the comment section, there's people like, oh, you fucking, I'm basically joining your camp, Chris, where they're like, you fucking, you leftist shill, you, I was like, oh.
You commie. You communist.
I was like, I explained before the video even got into it that I'm like, oh, I made a video about Trump and the salty aftermath. Now it's appropriate to do one for Biden. It's just equal playing field.
Favorites. Yeah, it's totally no playing favorites. Fair game is fair game, and you know, if you don't, all you had to do was not flip out. And you know, and then no video would happen because there would be no ammo. But there's a ton of ammo, as there always is with this kind of thing, especially in the modern. Like after 2016, I'm convinced every election is going to be just a massive meltdown. Like yeah. It's because I don't remember this meltdown really in 2012. I remember like a little bit of it in 2008. I remember there were people who like burned like an Obama effigy in like I don't know
an effigy.
Yeah, they burned like a
The fuck? Like the things you have in Dark Souls that you burn to get your humanity back? Someone burned one of those things?
I remember that. I remember a very vague. I have a vague recollection of that happening in like I don't know, like Mississippi or like some like one of those places.
Effigy.
Holy in 2008,
shit.
But that was as bad as I saw it. And in 2012, it was kind of like. I feel like barely anybody cared about that one. Like, I feel like 2012 was the year that everybody was like, you know.
Obama's just going to win again. Let him go.
Everybody obvious. Was like, everybody kind of assumed that Obama was going to win because incumbents typically win. And also just like, I don't know, Mitt Romney wasn't all that exciting. But I remember even in 2012 thinking like, I wasn't like, I liked Obama back then because he was obviously like super charismatic and he seemed chill. That was as far as, like, my politics lent.
Yeah.
But I remember being like, oh, you know, even if he loses, it's like, Mitt Romney seems fine, you know? Like, he just seems like a guy, you know? Like,
It was, like, pretty interchangeable. I mean, even, like, say, the biggest thing that everybody would talk about, like, the Affordable Care Act, Mitt Romney was the one that came up with that shit in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
And then Obama adopted it. So it was kind of like, I was like...
Yeah, it was
it's same shit.
It was basically like picking like a different character skin.
It was a skin, yeah. Do you want to be Slenderman? Do you want to be Enderman or do you want to be Steve? That's pretty much all it was.
Yeah, but it has been a wild ride on Twitter these past couple weeks. This election feels like, I mean, obviously because of all the mail-in ballots. It's felt like True. It's been going on for fucking ages. It felt like an election year, you know.
It has. It's been the worst.
If you guys want some good content, just if you're on Twitter, I would advise you to follow Terrence K. Williams with notifications on, because this little nigga is he just. He's just a step like under like the being pathetic like Trump, like the shit that he's tweeting, and it's sad, man. It looks like it's like his dad lost, you know, and it's some of the saddest shit, but it's so entertaining. Like I have the notifications on, and
I don't have notifications on for anyone.
you have to for that. Well, for this specific reason, I had to put him on. It was just too good.
I can't deal with it. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's.
Yeah. Other than that, I don't have notifications on for anybody else. I don't fucking.
Yeah. Fuck everybody.
Oh yeah, I've seen this guy. Yeah.
I have it on for my girlfriend. That's about it. She's the only person I have notifications on for.
That's because
I care about her when she speaks.
You fucking stalking her? Is that it?
No, I'm not. I already caught the bass. I'm not stalking anything. I'm just checking up on her.
Stalking
bass?
Are you stalking your girlfriend by having notifications on? Dude, man,
is having notifications on stalking your girl?
There's people like that, man. There's people that fucking that are just, you know, they're insane. They every they have to know where you are at every given moment, and they those type of people usually turn into serial murderers, because I've seen them on the true crimes like all the fucking time. It's all the time. Like, oh.
I won, bro. I won already. I did it. I caught that thing. I opened that chest. I did the whole Zelda thing. Put it up in the air. I won it. I'm not stopping anything.
Let's just all calm down. I think this whole, I don't know, man. This election has felt so fucking weird. But I think the fact that what's so surprising, I think, about this whole thing is how surprised everybody is by it. Not necessarily by the outcome, necessarily by like who won and who lost, because I honestly feel like it could have been like a complete toss up. I was fully expecting Trump to win, simply because the incumbent typically wins, and that's like just a pretty safe rule to bet on. Didn't happen this time, but the fact that everybody was like surprised, it's like, oh hey, Trump's not conceding, even though he said he wouldn't, and like, oh, the mail-in ballots are taking forever to count, like we all knew they would. Oh, the mail-in ballots are pretty much unanimously or almost unanimously blue, like we would have assumed would happen anyway. Because Trump was out there saying how stupid mail-in ballots were. Like, what do you... I don't know how you don't expect that kind of thing, you know?
What do you expect to happen?
I mean, the problem is, and this is... I saw a compilation of, and I don't watch Tim Pool's videos, but there's a compilation circulating around with his predictions about the election. He has a very large audience.
Yeah.
So you have to imagine a lot of these people suspected Trump to destroy Biden because of how often he was saying shit like that. And I was wondering, who else was saying that? I don't know.
Yeah, what did he say? Like 49 state landslide.
Yeah,
how could you?
He's gonna get like
49
all
states?
The electoral. Yes. That's what he's saying. Like, it's just gonna be a landslide. He's gonna get the vast majority, like 500 fucking electoral votes. Like, I was just like,
wait a minute. That's so insane.
You guys are listening.
Unbelievable statement. There's 49 states. There's at least, I'm gonna say, there's 13 states that are just blue states, if I'm not mistaken, without any of the toss-up states.
No. They thought. This is real. People thought that Trump was going to take California. Like, genuinely. Yeah. People thought that was going to happen.
Dude, you know what's crazy? After looking at the votes, I was like, seeing all the places in New York that voted red. Dude, a lot of New York votes red. I never knew that.
Well, yeah.
I thought that,
New York is mostly, like, farmland. Like, it's mostly, like,
yeah.
It's mostly
out of
nothing.
The city. Once you leave New York City, it's, like, farmland.
But yeah. The city,
like, other than like White Plains, Westchester.
Where California is huge, and most of it is like barren farm shit, and a bunch of like, say, the deserty parts where a lot of the, you know, the good old boys with giant trucks, they move into like the Inland Empire, they move into South Orange County, and like that shit's all conservative. And then there's just like the metro, metropolis is that where most people live, and that's how it becomes blue. You know,
that's insane. Yeah. Dude. It's just wild to me how much of the state that I lived in that I thought was like, oh, this is a blue state by like a vast majority. And it is solely because of the city. The city's full of people. And like it just landslides everywhere else.
That's kind of the thing. It's like New York is so populated, so densely populated, and so goddamn big that, like, you know, you have all these red counties in New York, but it looks like a lot of land. But, like, all that land...
It's a lot of land mass, but it's not
all that
people,
land that, like, votes red in, like, a single county in upstate New York is probably, like, maybe, like, 5 square city blocks. You know? Like, it's... not a lot of people. There's just not a lot of people there. There are towns that have numbers in the hundreds, you know? And it's just fucking insane.
Hundreds.
But...
Imagine there'd be 100 people. There's 15 people in your graduating class. That's it.
I just don't know how you could have possibly believed. Like, that's the thing. It's like Tim Pool. Like, I know. Like, I've met Tim Pool. I've spoken with him. I've hung out with him a couple times. I know. And, like, we haven't been getting along lately. But, like, I know he's not a stupid person. Like, he's not, like, an uneducated guy. Like, he's a pretty smart dude. I can't even fathom how he came to that conclusion. Either he's just completely out of his fucking gourd. Or he's just misleading people on purpose.
Bro.
I don't know. Because 49 state landslide, dude, a 49 state landslide is an insane prediction. Like
Who's ever had 49 states? Anyone ever had 49
like
states?
Like in the beginning of the country, maybe. Like it's been
not even then, bro.
Well, there weren't
not
even there then. Weren't, well, that's because there weren't 49 states, but like a similar, you know, a similar like landslides that they did happen kind of frequently, like earlier on. But like in the last like 50 years, I feel like it's been.
I don't think Washington had 49 states, bro. I don't think he had 49 states, like the same percentage. Right, right. Like that's a lot, bro.
It's an insane prediction, especially considering like everybody's touting like we are living in the most divisive political time of modern history. Everyone's at each other's throats. Everyone's really divided and diametrically opposed. Therefore, a 49 state landslide? Like
that's power right there, man.
How could you possibly?
To me it comes down to two things. Either it's just a grift and it gets like the viewers happy, more of them pour in, they're feeling good, or when you're just watching programs that just say shit like that, like he could just be watching conservative programs and they're saying the same shit and he's just saying, you know, regurgitating what they're saying. Because
honestly,
because nobody, like my prediction was Biden was going to take it because of COVID. That was my, it made sense to me. Like, yeah. I think Trump would have won if the pandemic didn't happen. But that was the just tipped everybody was like, fuck this, dude. Fuck this orange piece of shit. And I can't fucking go anywhere. This could have been done a lot better, but he doesn't give a fuck. And that's it.
That's honestly my failing point with him, too. I think he just handled COVID horribly.
Yeah.
Like, that's as simple as what it is. It's like, oh, he's handled this really badly.
I don't know if anyone would have handled it. It still would have been bad, but there was no
there was no effort for him to try to get people to be responsible.
That is true. He definitely didn't help at all.
Insulted
like,
mask wearing.
But was very something that is true. Which is kind of wild. Trump wanted to actually give a lot of people stimulus checks. And then Nancy Pelosi and Mitch McConnell, the two heads of the stupid dragon, didn't want to do it for various reasons that are probably really stupid. Although obviously Trump only wanted to do it so he could write his name on the check.
Trump only wanted to do it because he wanted the popular support, right?
Oh yeah, no. Everybody's going to love the guy who gives him free money.
Yeah, Pelosi and Mitch and all, they literally just for the same reason Trump wanted to do it was the reason why they didn't want him to do it. How do you have people represent you, but not represent you, and then they still
so
get
fucking crazy, dude.
Reelected?
It is wild. Like, it is pretty fucking. It's staggering. But
like for me personally, like I understand politics because I've taken like a bunch of poli sci classes, and that's how I understand like the basis of politics at least. But as soon as I understood, I was like, oh, everyone's just the same. There's no group of like the Democrats or the Republicans. No one gives a fuck about odd people. They just want to be rich. That's all of them.
Oh, yeah.
And like, I don't get how other, that's such an obvious thing. Like, if you can't see that now, like, I don't know how you can't understand that. Just simply think of it like this. Like, I'm a Bernie boy. I'm not going to act like I'm not. I'm very much so a Bernie boy. But the simple fact that he just wanted health care in this country for everybody. That's a unanimous plus across the board for every human
in
this country.
I mean, JFK was talking about that stuff. And
so was, dude, a lot of people were talking about it.
Yeah, but like, I like to bring up JFK because he's not a modern president. You know, he's like from like, a lot of people would argue like kind of like a time period that a lot of, you know, conservative people are really nostalgic for. And I think like, nobody was going to call him. No one was going to be like, oh, Kennedy's a commie. Like, I don't know any right wing person who would say that.
I mean, he was fighting the commies at the moment. So he was like,
that's what I'm saying. It's
commies,
like,
so that's pretty crass. Pretty hard to call him a commie.
Right.
At that moment.
That's what I'm saying. It's like it's the same exact opinion that I'm called a commie for right now. And it's like just this opinion, this generic opinion from the 60s. You know, it's not even that. But I do think like, I don't know, man, it's not necessarily defense of Trump to say that like, oh, anybody would have handled this poorly, but it's like, it's really, I don't imagine, regardless of who was in the White House, I think they would have lost this election. Because
you think so?
I think so, because I think when you have a president who is just associated with a pandemic, you know, like, I think even regard, like, obviously, like, there's a chance that somebody could have done the job, like, super well, and very few people would have gotten sick, but I don't even think that's possible in the United States because of, like, the culture that we have we have a very, like, anti-authoritarian culture, which is good in a lot of ways, but it also kind of bites us in the ass whenever the government recommends something that's fairly common sense, and we just go, like, no, the government told us that, so fuck that.
I agree. I very much so agree with that.
And, you know, I think it would have gotten bad regardless, and I think the person who was in the White House in the middle of it would have just been fucked regardless. Although, you know, I do think before the whole pandemic thing, I do think, like, Trump would have had a pretty easy time. Like, I don't think anybody would have really been that motivated to vote for Biden if not for all this crazy shit.
I think that I agree with you in the fact that no one would have handled it very well. I don't think it could have been handled very well, but I think that a lot of lives could have been saved if it was tackled the right way from the beginning.
Oh yeah, no, obviously.
I think
yeah.
from the very beginning where he had information, he just didn't disclose it the right way. Like, you don't have to come up and create mass hysteria by talking about the COVID, because even when you did, West Ham wasn't created. People were frightened because,
well,
you know, it's a pandemic.
Let's just knock this. Oh, he didn't want to cause a panic shit. It's don't argue that. That's such a dumb argument, because he's on Twitter causing panic every day. Like, literally every day.
That was his excuse, though.
It was obviously his excuse, but there are people who believe it. It's like, oh, he just didn't want to cause a panic. It's like, are you fucking kidding me, dude? This dude's, like, calling people to arms because he lost an election. Like, there's no way this guy cares about causing a panic or not. He just didn't want to do it because, like, he didn't want to look bad. And that's pretty in keeping with his character, and I think that's totally, like, I don't know, like, you could predict that a mile away, dude.
Yeah. You know? I think anyone would have been, as a president, would have been like, ah, oh, fuck, this is going to suck. Me talking about, oh, this is a fucking plague coming to the world and people are going to die, not probably. You know, like, it's really bad. But I mean, I think that if it depends on who was in, I think very much so. But yeah, I think overall would have been bad.
No, obviously.
If Obama was in, shit would have been fucking smooth. Because he just would have been like, let's play some basketball. And then fucking people would be like, oh, it's dope.
Now me and my dog Bo here.
We have invented drones that can shoot viruses right out the sky.
Well, we're gonna drone strike people. We're gonna drone strike people, okay? But listen here, me and my dog Bo, Sasha, Malia, and Michelle, we're all gonna be fine, right? We're inside our bunker. We're not gonna
Don't forget about Obama drone striking people with fucking COVID.
We're gonna send all the virus to Flint, Michigan.
Drink the water. It'll be fine. There's fucking pencils and COVID in the water now. Turn on your faucet and a pencil falls into your cup. Do you imagine that?
Jesus.
What if we found out that Obama has a grudge with Flint, and that's why, like, their water specifically fucked up because he did it on purpose.
He dated a girl from Flint and she broke his heart, so he decided to just poison the water supply.
Poison everybody.
His office in Detroit? Guys, wasn't his office in Detroit, if I'm not mistaken?
Huh?
What?
He was his office was in Detroit, right? He was a senator in Detroit, right? Was it Detroit? It was Michigan.
Honestly, I didn't know shit about him before he started running for president.
I didn't know. I
knew he was a senator, but I didn't know. I didn't know fuck all about him. Wow. Never heard
he was
him
involved
once or anything.
Yeah,
it was actually kind of interesting. It was. I mean, I was barely paying attention to politics at that point anyway. Mm-hmm. But it was just like, who the fuck's this guy? And I was like, he seems pretty dope. And then, you know, after a few years of being in office, I was like, oh, okay, never mind.
Yeah, he's just a president. Like, oh yeah, he's just a president.
Had a jump shot other than him.
But yeah,
I mean, that was dope. I liked seeing his March Madness predictions. I was like, this. I hate that you're doing this for, like, a bread and circuses thing. Like, you're distracting people, but I still like it. I still like. I would watch him. Meet, like, fucking with the here's the NBA champions and stuff like that, and he meets with them and he's all fucking around. And I watched his speech. He gave a speech for Biden. Like, it was like a 30-minute speech, and it was like, it was good, but it's funny because I'm like, this is all bullshit, but it's still such a good speech. Yeah, because yeah. I
likable dude,
know,
man.
Yeah, he's so charismatic, and I'm like, I know all the stuff that fucking you like continued all the shit that Bush started, but like you're somehow saying that Trump's a tyrant too or something. I'm like, okay, whatever, that's fine. I just keep shooting them, keep shooting them Jays, man, because yeah. they're pretty.
He has a jumper, bro. He really does. Like, he's old now. He's too busy, like, trying to cover up the fact that he killed so many people in the Middle East, but he still has a jump shot, bro. You can't deny it. He still has the eye jammer, bro. He'll still pull up on you from three-point range, sink that jump shot, and then be like, well, man, should have stepped up next time.
It must be fascinating to be that person, though. It must be fascinating to be just the guy who's like a general comes to you, and he's like, listen, it's World War II. The Japanese are just not going to stop, my guy. Like, what do you want to do? And they give you, like, two options. And they're both, like... And it's just like a... It's like a Telltale video game. And it's just, like, multiple choice. And you're just like, I don't know. I guess bomb? And, like... And then, dude, and then a little notification in the top left corner comes up and says, everyone will remember that.
And then,
oh my god! Like in Walking Dead.
Yeah, like in Walking Dead, and it's just like, just to like come out of office after something like that is just like, oh, that's interesting.
Dude, it's wild.
Yeah, because like they can't. What do you think the likelihood of him getting? We won't stay on politics for too much longer. It's just we cannot not mention the election.
Yeah, it just happened.
Dude, but what do you think insane. What do you think the likelihood of him going to jail is?
Zero.
Yeah, obviously.
Well, zero. He's the president.
Zero.
Yeah, no, exactly. I mean, there's so many. I've seen so many tweets of like, oh man, he's just throwing a fit because he's gonna get arrested once he leaves. It's like, nah, dude. The presidents are like essentially above
if
the law.
Anything, he can get indicted for shit that has nothing to do with the presidency, with his taxes and stuff like that. Him as a person, but as far as like, oh, this war crimes or anything like that, anything that he did that's technically illegal, no, because it's going to set that precedent, right?
Yeah,
that if, absolutely. If you prosecute somebody, the president, then it's like, fuck.
Then really only the crazy people are going to want to be president, because like, imagine imagine wanting to be president knowing that like the second you leave office, you're basically just fucked.
You're tangible.
Yeah,
again.
You're just
they can
you're
see you. You're
totally
like Danny Phantom coming out of his fucking ghost form. You're like, holy shit, yeah. They can touch me now.
If Danny Phantom goes into ghost form and then steps like half his body into a wall, right, and then goes into human form again, does his corporeal form take precedent over the matter that he's phasing through? Like, would he
I don't know.
Like,
that's what
like. If he flew up, like, let's say, like, his torso is, like, he's on the ground, right? And he's comes out of the floor, like, oh, man, hey, what's up? It's me, Danny Phantom. And then he goes fucking corporeal. Is he going to be cut in half, or is there just going to be, like, a Danny-shaped hole in the floor?
No, the matter's still there.
Thought about that.
What do you mean the matter's
still
there?
The matter's still there. Like, the matter that is the floor is still there. So matter can't take the space of other matter, you know? So it's just going to get ripped in half. It's just going to get ripped in half and separated. He's not going to be like, oh, it's going to be a top half of Danny and a bottom half of Danny. It's severed.
That would be, I used to think that I wanted powers like that, and that just totally scared me straight. Like, imagine fucking up just a little bit. What?
Do you float when you go, like, when you use your corporeal form, do you fall through the floor? Like, would you fall into the center of the earth? Technically, through the center of the earth?
Do I float? I don't know. I've never floated.
Would you go to space eventually? Would you float or would you,
like... Like, I don't know. Like, would you put pulled by gravity still? Do you get escape from gravity when you no longer... Well, you probably don't get pulled by gravity.
No, you wouldn't. That's probably crazy. Yeah, you wouldn't be pulled by gravity because you would have no mass.
You would just fucking go to space after a while.
But hold on a second. But doesn't that mean that you're technically not tethered? So you're not...
That's why I can fly.
But you're not tethered to Earth. Does that mean you would just sort of, like, the second you go, like, ghost, would you just be, like... whizzing through the world because the world is spinning so fast?
I'd assume what happens is you're no longer bound by the laws of, like, relative matter. So you don't do anything you don't want to do. You but can like just you, stay where you want, or you can fly, or you could just do whatever you want.
Right, but if you're going incorporeal and then, like, you know, you're no longer tethered to Earth's gravity. That theoretically means that you would be flying through. Like, the second you stopped, you would be, like, whizzing through things as fast as the planet is spinning, right?
It would mean that if you were a thing that still had to obey the rules of physics once you do that. But if you don't get pulled by gravity, you probably aren't going to be affected by the rotation of the Earth either, because you just don't get affected by shit.
This is
no
some
more.
Nerd shit. Fuck you.
You're playing a different video game from everybody else. People are playing Red Dead. You're playing fucking Garry's Mod. You know?
Oh yeah.
Is this everything's fucking
well,
different?
Well, speaking of video games, next gen, it's here, and
yes, here.
Yo, the PS5 is so big.
Yeah, I can see. It looks like a boat.
It's so goddamn unnecessarily big.
Lucky you, Chris.
No consoles. I don't have any. I'll get a PS5 when the next God of War comes out. And then
I want one so bad. I want a PS5 so fucking badly. And I ordered it, but what happened was it outsold before I can get my pre-order.
That's pretty much how
that was. Like, fantastic.
Dude, I'm sure if people follow me on Twitter, they know this already. But they fucking put my PS5 in the building across the fucking street. I had to break into a building to get my package. I love Amazon. Amazon's so cool.
That's crazy. Like, I have nothing but good experiences with Amazon. Like, I think I'm just lucky.
Dude, this was the first time anything like this has happened. Like, I couldn't even fathom. Because, like, the addresses aren't even really similar, you know? So it's like, what?
At all.
Why is my box in a different, like, at least put it in, like, at the very least, if they put it in front of, like, a different door, like, maybe not my, okay, at least you got the building, right? And my name is on it and shit and my address, but, like, they just left it in another building.
That's crazy. I got lucky that no one didn't just fucking snag that shit.
Yo, they were fucking with the tape, dude. I picked up the box and I saw the tape was fucked with. People were trying to look inside. I was so fucking livid, man. I was on customer service. I was on customer support with like Amazon and like UPS and shit.
I want another PS5. I'm like, now. Send me another one.
Dude, they were like, oh, don't worry. We can just refund you and replace it. It's like, dude, do you know how many of these are even...
exist?
In existence, like you can't just magically replace this shit.
They
I don't want
could,
a refund. Man. No, you can't. That thing's not going to come
probably,
for a while. Like,
Amazon
still,
probably has enough of them.
I still don't know where the hell my Xbox is. Like, I pre-ordered both of them because I like to talk about it for the podcast, but for Sacred Symbols, and it's like, my Xbox Series X pre-order still says order received. So I guess you know
lucky
whatever.
You.
Yeah, well,
I want one so fucking badly.
Why though? Why?
Because I just want a new console. That's it. The PS4 has run its course, and not a new one exists, and I'd like it.
New consoles are nice. Like I just like opening. I like new hardware. Whenever there's like a nice feeling that you get whenever you open like a box and it's got like a fucking, especially with video games when it's like you know this a new generation happens like what like once every 7 years at this point is like the average. So it is kind of like a nice little thing to experience. It is fucking really cool. Like Demon's Souls is fucking great.
I'm surprised you didn't get it for that, Derek.
And it looks goddamn gorgeous, but
it's
just too expensive
for
Demon's Souls.
You know, I have it for PS3, so it's kind of like, oh, I'll play the remastered eventually. Because that was kind of like the thing that I lagged on for a long time, Demon's Souls. But then I got this PS3 emulator, and then I was like, cool, cool, cool. But that looks good, but it's not good enough for me to want to just throw $500 just for Demon's Souls because it's relatively, I know what the game is, and I know it just looks great. It's just everything's kind of upgraded and stuff, which is fucking cool. But it's not something like God of War. That's enough for me. It's going to be, the console's going to be out for a long time. There's going to be a lot of other shit that's out there. I mean, the only day one thing I've ever got was Switch, and then I sold it like a month later, afterwards, because I just, I don't know, I'm not like it. That's just me. It's just a personal thing. I don't really like go crazy about shit, especially. I'd be pissed off if there was like issues. You know, your day one shit, and then a lot of times there's a lot of defective shit. And I'm like, fuck that. I'll just wait.
I hear you. There are some day one issues with the PS5 that are kind of like really, really weird. None that are necessarily like super detrimental. I would say, but they're a little weird. Like I remember, like I was playing Miles Morales, Spider-Man Miles Morales, and like it's really good, by the way. I finished it; it's fantastic. But
it's a great game.
But the you know, I was playing it, and one of my friends came into the room, and he was like, "Oh yeah, you got it." I was like, "Yeah, yeah." And I was trying to show them like the UI, so I went back to the home screen and I started Miles Morales again, and it's restarted the game, and I was like, "Oh weird." And then, like, the performance mode was missing, and it, like, wasn't running in 60 frames per second, and I lost all my saves. I was like, what the fuck is... What is this? What is happening? And I realized that apparently, like, it ran the PS4 version on the PS5, and those apparently aren't the same thing. So it's just a completely different game. It was the most baffling fucking thing I've ever experienced. Because on, like, every other... On PC, that's not how that works. On Xbox, that's not how it works. Like, if you run a game that you already own on more powerful hardware, it's the same fucking game. It just runs better. And that's how it runs on that's how it works on PC. It's how it works on the Xbox consoles. In this one, they're two separate games entirely. And it's like,
I don't know.
Really Maybe fucking weird.
You bought the PS4 version, but even then that's kind of weird. I don't know. I don't know how to explain
really
that.
Really, it's just a design quirk because like there's no real way to tell the difference, which is the real nuisance, but I don't know. I like being there to like tweet about that shit, so that way like be like, hey, you know, this is a fucking actual issue with the PlayStation 5, so that way people, you know, if they're, you know, jelly or whatever, they can at least, you know, see that there's issues that'll get worked out by the time that they get their shit.
For me, I just wanted to play Destiny at 60 frames per second, and I don't have to learn how to use mouse and keyboard, because that shit is killing me. Mouse and keyboard is fucking alien to my mind. I feel like a fucking chimpanzee playing it. I'm just like, this doesn't fucking make sense.
Just plug in your fucking controller. What are you talking about?
Controller's not as good.
It is if you're good.
I'm trying to... I'm pretty decent. I'm pretty decent at Destiny.
Kingston, I play on controller. Like, I play on controller on PC.
What do you mean the
controller's
not as good? What are you talking about?
It's just you can't do... It's not as precise. That's about
it. Yeah, but like, what? I mean...
It's not a huge... It's not an unbelievable level of margin, but it is. It's a little
wait,
bit. It's a bit of
what are you talking about? Like, you play... Like, you usually play on PS4, right?
Yes. So, but on PS4, it's 30 frames per second with, like, 65 FOV.
Yeah, so take your PS4 controller and play on your PC.
But it's not as precise.
Why is it not as precise? What are you talking about? Are you talking about the fucking latency?
It's not quite as precise.
He's talking about, like, because it's a PvP game, he's playing with people who have access to mouse and keyboard who are, like, way more precise than you can do.
That's what you're talking about. You're like,
I need the precision.
You want to play. But, dude, no, you don't need precision. You want to play with people that aren't as good. That's what you're saying.
Oh, no. Once it goes to PS5, it'll be the same capabilities. It'll be the exact same kind of game for a console, PS5 and console, a console and PC at that moment. So when it comes to console at 60 frames, I'm like, oh, I'm just going to play this because I don't have to murder my fucking stupid ass hands that are used to holding a controller, not used to fucking pressing
you understand,
keys to do shit.
You understand that Destiny's getting crossplay soon with PC and other
consoles.
Well,
once that happens, then I'll deal with that. But until then, I'll live on console as a king. A king among men.
That's what I'm saying. You're fucking... That's like mastering, like... not easy, but just medium mode, right? Or something like the normal mode. You're like, I'm the shit, and then you don't want to move up to hard mode.
Why is somebody in a comfort zone when you don't have to?
I mean,
I'm going to keep playing mouse and key because I'm going to get good at it. I'm going to have to eventually be able to do it.
I'll tell you something. I play PvP competitive FPS video games on PC with controller, and I do fucking great. Like, there's no...
I can do fine. I can even play Trials on controller, but I just can't hit the shots they hit. I just can't. Like, I can snipe somebody. I can put a bullet in between someone's fucking eyes. But
I can't snipe in anything anymore with regard, like, mouse and keyboard controller. I just can't do it. So I've just given up on that, like, necessity for precision. It's just not necessary.
I've recently acquired the ability to be able to snipe using controller.
Anyway,
on PC I can do it because it's just click on someone's face when they run past you.
I don't know.
Quickly just do a little twitch and click on someone's face. But I'm just not good at moving around. I'm horrible at it, actually. I run into fucking walls. People get too close to me. I freak out, and I press every button but the melee button.
It's because you're a fucking terrible. Spastic, man. You're a goddamn spaz.
I am. I am spastic. That's why I'm good at fighting games.
Well, Sweeney, why don't you, look, since you have a PC, why don't you, put a couple of trainers on, just fucking cheat.
I'm not going to do that.
Just become king of the hill.
I can't do it.
The fucking until you get banned eventually.
Yeah, Destiny is actually cracking down on that shit now. I think they send.
I've thought about cheating before.
I think they send well, like Bungie police officers. Like they have their own police. I didn't know this, but they send Bungie police to your door and they wring your dog out like a wet towel.
Sure.
And they beat you to death with
your dog without popping it. The dog doesn't pop, it just gets wrung out.
They've mastered a method to wring a dog out without popping it.
Oh.
I don't know how they do it. And if you don't have a dog, they'll get one and it'll still be sad because you're watching police murder a dog for no good reason.
That's a very good use of resources.
Yeah, I mean
they
got a lot of money.
Good means of punishment, bro. That'll get the point across to any fucking body.
Nobody wants to be beaten to death with a dog.
Yorkie.
You know?
They brought this baby Yorkie in my house and they wrung it the fuck out in front of me. You know what that feels like?
I don't know, man. Oh my god!
Yeah. I've always wanted to.
My dog out, bro.
I would always get so pissed at people cheating in Call of Duty when I played back in the day that I've always had I always wanted to try it, but I'd never bring myself to do it just because of I was so. It was a thing that ultimately made me stop playing multiplayer because it just got ridiculous back in the day. And I was like, I don't fucking care enough. But I've always at the same time wanted to feel what it's like to just cheese and do the most stupidest bullshit. Like people fucking standing in one place and killing everybody. It just kills everybody by just standing in one place. So I'm like...
Yeah.
Why are you playing?
You could do that.
How is that fun? How is that fun?
You could do that in the older Call of Duties that everybody's cheating in anyway, and
World at War. Holy shit, World at War on PC was ridiculous.
Dude, if you play Modern Warfare, I played Modern Warfare 2 kind of recently, the original one.
It's fucked. I played it a couple years ago.
Yeah, because it's backwards compatible on Xbox. So I was playing. I was like, oh, I'm curious as to how this is, because I remember liking it a lot, and then I go in and I'm. Men are flying. It's Destiny, basically. Yo, this is a different realm. And I'm playing fucking Sorry, and they're playing Risk. You know, I'm in a different realm of possibilities.
You're having a crossword puzzle. They're playing fucking Jenga, bro. That's a difference. Two different realms.
Yeah, totally different. But I think, I don't know, the only way that I could see myself cheating in any video game is A, if the video game is old enough that nobody cares about it, or B, there are people with microphones around to react to it. Because I feel like that's I feel like it's Minecraft and I just poured lava on your fucking house that you spent 5 days making.
Dickhead.
That's the equivalent. It's such a good emotion though. It's
just making people upset.
No, just the feeling of pouring lava on someone's creation in Minecraft is it might be the best feeling that exists.
I don't think that's the best feeling that exists. It is, maybe to you, because you're hurting people.
Well,
maybe to you that's fantastic.
I mean, I'm not denying that, but I think.
Fucking
I don't know. There's just something satisfying. I love griefing, but that's why. I grief for a little bit and then I put the game down. I don't sit there for 5 years and fuck with people. It's not my style. I do it once, twice, three times, and then I'm out. You know.
Ouch. I don't mind. I'm not above cheating, actually. I'm not above cheating. I was taught the rule: if you're not cheating, you're not trying, at a very young age. Maybe I was 14 and my basketball coach, my JV coach, told me that, and that shit stuck with me. And I was like, you know what? Absolutely.
Your JV coach told you that?
I hate that shit.
I've definitely ball tapped people on picks, on the ISO. I've definitely stepped on people's feet knowing they're gonna lunge so they fall down. I'm not above it. But when you cheat in a video game, it's just come on, dude. get your mind right. You know, we're playing this for fun and you're cheating in this thing for fun. We're not getting prestige for this. You're not going to go to fucking varsity or UV for this. You're just being a dickhead. You know, you're not going to go to university for beating me in Destiny, you fucking jackass.
Why are you The funny thing is, morally, it should be the fucking opposite, where it's like, hey, cheat in a fucking game. Who gives a fuck? It's a game. But people in real life, to get a leg up in the world, they cheat all the fucking time, right? That's where it's much more like, you know, it's not, you're not supposed to. It's just that
you're supposed to.
It becomes he's cheating, so I'll cheat. That's how it becomes.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It's like a domino effect. Yeah.
Derek, look, if you care enough about something, you'll do anything you can to win.
You're crazy. That's
such a bullshit fucking mentality.
That's a scary mentality.
That's not a bullshit mentality. That is not a bullshit. You try your hardest, but you give it the extra amount that you're going to fucking win. I'm not saying take drugs and enhance yourself and get fucking bionics.
That's exactly what it is. That's literally
but
what
I'm just saying, like, hey, you know, like,
that's cheating.
Like, if this guy's putting a pick on you, you know, actually, no, I don't really even care if people take fucking enhancement drugs. As long as they admit it. But
Hold on. I'm going to just go ahead and say, like, I would prefer there be no cheating. But I would definitely prefer there be no cheating. But, and this is a huge, huge asterisk next to this. If people want to cheat, they should be in their own cheating league. Because I want to see people who are cheating cheat against each other.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I want to see people. I want people who are like
sanctioned cheating.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I want a baseball league.
So like cheating league.
I would love that.
I want a baseball league where everyone's roided. Just everyone's roided out. Balls are flying at like 200 miles an hour.
Yeah. The bat looks like the Rock.
There can't be any planes in the sky. You know, I want that. I'm totally fine with that.
I agree.
But the other game needs to exist.
Performance enhancing.
And you know what? If you get caught cheating, in like normal sports, like if you get caught cheating in like normal football, they send you to cheat football, where like people don't wear where people aren't wearing helmets and like punching is fine and like all this crazy shit. And you're surrounded by roided out people with like hidden fucking blades, like it's Assassin's Creed,
hidden
cutting people's tendons.
Blades.
There goes your femoral artery.
Now, his fucking sweatbands. It's a fucking hidden knife that comes out of his sweatband, stabs you.
I'm all right with it.
You know that league would last for one season because everybody would be fucking dead.
Let me tell you, Derek.
Ever come
it'd be
back.
The
they'd
best
have their one
goddamn
season. And they
season.
Would die off.
Yeah,
in
that's
mid-season,
it.
And you have to replace them.
No, it would be the best goddamn season of anything that's ever existed.
Well, I agree with that.
I have no problem with cheating. I have no problem with cheating in the sense of like, if this guy's you know, sticking on you a little bit too much in ball, you know, you put your leg out, you know, pay attention
to
where you're walking.
To me, that's not cheating. That's just dirty. It's like, say, the term in boxing, dirty boxing, right? Where there's people that are just traditionally boxing, and then you clinch, you fucking try to, when you break on the clinch, you try to uppercut a motherfucker. Then if they're getting too close, you clinch them again. You know, like, there's this dirty boxing where it's like a very kind of shady thing to do, but it's very tactical.
It's warriors,
and a lot of people fucking, you know, won championships that way by just being dirty as fuck. So I'm totally fine with having an edge and doing, like, fucking Kobe, man. Kobe was a disgusting fucking player, the way that he would play. Like, he would go for a rebound, and he would fucking, like, elbow a motherfucker in the back, like, just while, like, he's coming down,
oh,
just to make
God.
Sure to take
Come
you
on.
Out of the game.
Don't start with the accusations of Kobe. Kobe played defense like someone who played defense in the time when he went into the league. He played defense like a 90s player because
back in the 90s,
people were getting punched in the mouth when they went up for dunks, dog.
Yeah, I have no problem with fucking the 80s, 90s, and early 90s era of basketball. The fucking compilations, if you look up compilations on YouTube, where just people are getting fucked up and there's fights every game, it almost becomes like hockey.
I love it.
It's because people are just fighting each other. Yeah. No, it was cool. I'm not even shitting on Kobe. I'm just saying, technically, he was a fucking piece of shit. Like, technically.
Hockey is some of the craziest shit I've ever seen. People just that's just fighting with a sport kind of around it, you know, for show, for like show and like for progression. But like that show is that sport is literally just about people beating each other with sticks on ice.
Hockey is just white barbarian soccer with fighting in it. That's it. It's just barbarian white people soccer.
It is. It's ice soccer with like sticks.
But it's more, has more rules, as like a quite a bit more rules than soccer. But like it's
just, if you boil everything down, everything is really just sort of, you know, get this thing into this thing, you know.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, when you go oversimplify the whole fucking world, and yes, you're very right. Everything is bring this to this.
Well, that's what you just did.
Yeah, even sex.
Food.
What up?
But soccer and hockey are, like, very similar. Like, even the way they're laid out, actually. They're similar.
Or, like, the
games.
Formations and stuff.
Yeah, like the fact that they're,
even the formations,
yeah, like they're both on ice.
Basketball is like soccer, too, a little bit, too.
Soccer would be so much better if the field wasn't fucking 20 fucking miles long. It would be nice if they just compacted it like a hockey rink.
I love soccer.
I would like soccer a lot. I played it a lot when I was young, 6th and 7th grade mostly, but our fields were much smaller. Like the fucking professional soccer fields, I can't, dude. Like they're too fucking big. So they spend. So it's 90 minutes, right? Yeah. I used to go to like LA Galaxy and shit. And they spend about 60 minutes of the 90 minutes passing because of how fucking long and wide the field is. It's like, dude, shorten it. No, it doesn't. It's just a tradition. I'm like, dude, narrow that shit. Narrow it. It would be so much better.
Soccer would be better if it was on ice, but everything else was the same.
What does that mean? How would you play?
It's just soccer, but like everybody's wearing the same exact shit. Nobody has ice skates. Everybody's in shorts.
You can't tell who's on your team or at all. You're just like, I don't know who's on. So it's pretty much just kill the carrier. So he's saying kill the carrier on ice is better than soccer.
No, it's just soccer. Everything, it's just soccer, but take the grass out and put ice. It's the same thing. Everything's the same.
So do you have to wear cleats?
That's so
yeah,
ridiculous.
You have to wear cleats. You have to wear cleats. You have
die.
To wear shorts. You have
that
to wear shorts.
So
no protective gear. The goals cannot be rooted onto the field. They can slide around.
What does that mean? They can slide alongside the people.
They can slide around.
Yeah. You could move the goals if you want.
Are the goals as wide as the regular soccer goals or like the hockey goals?
They're wider to compensate for the fact that they can move.
Okay.
Dude, this will happen. It'd be the first game, right? And it'd be a bunch of times where people almost got goals, right? And someone would run. Someone would run with the cleats. And they'd be like, hey, try not to run with the cleats. And someone would fucking go for it. And they would burst their head open like a fucking watermelon on ice. And that would be the end of the game. No one ever played
it. Oh, yeah,
again.
No. The ice will be red.
Like, yo, I've come so close to scoring 3 times, man. I'm going to run it. I'm going to run for it. And he's going to slip and he's going to end up like fucking... like fucking JFK, bro. He's gonna fucking be headless. He's gonna be fucking Ichabod Crane on the fucking ice court.
I mean, cleats are pretty good for ice, right? They're basically like ice
pick
shoes.
Yeah. No, they're not.
Yeah, that's,
you ever put
yeah.
on cleats?
That's so fucking ridiculous. Like, I really want to see that though. literally, everyone is just gonna be trying to balance. That's all that's happening. It's just going to be fucking however long the regulation is. Is it going to be like 90 minutes just like that? And literally everybody's just trying to fucking balance and not fall. That's going to be the entire
game. Someone's
going to
die, bro.
That's
Someone
gonna be the
will
fucking game.
Die.
It's just going to be a bunch of people like not balancing very well and then deciding to come together to form some kind of Voltron character to get their way through the ice.
I like it.
You know what's going to be? It's going to be a bunch of passing. It's going to be even more passing than regular soccer, actually.
Yeah, it's passing away.
You know, like,
people
I can't do this. Kick it to that guy.
Colliding with the ice. Yo, ice is scary, man. Like, I don't know. Like, I remember, like, I went ice skating kind of recently, like, in, like, the last, like, year or two. And, like, I felt paralyzed by the ice. Like, I felt like, oh, my God. I if I fall, I'm going
to
die. I don't know what it is. Huh?
Did you forget how to ice skate?
The last time I ice skated before then was, like, I must have been, like, 9 or 10. Like, it's been a long fucking time. I know how to like
fast though.
You know what it is? Like I know how to move. Like I understand the basic premise of like how to push yourself through the ice. The issue that I have is like the ice skates never feel right around my ankles, so it always feels like I'm like really close to just snapping my foot off. Even though I know that that's not going to happen, I think it's like apprehensive. It's like an apprehensive
probably
kind
hurt
of
your ankle
fear.
Before, that's why.
Yeah, yeah. I've hurt my ankle before. My legs have been through so much pain. I've dislocated my knee like 40 times, it feels like, you know. So like that was another thing where I was like, oh my God, my knees are in so much stress right now on the ice. But I don't know. Like I'm just not. I also just don't have good balance, I don't think. So ice skating was just like,
ice skating is fucking,
I think,
dope.
I had better balance when I was smaller, when I was like a child and I could ice skate and I was like, I'm just close to the ground anyway, you know.
Oh yeah, as a child it's easy to fall. For me it takes like 3 minutes for me to fucking finally hit the ground with a giant thud. For a kid, they're just there already. They fall to the floor, which they're on already.
Yeah, and I'm just never prepared for ice skating either. I'm never wearing the right fucking gloves. So I always, I'm never even wearing gloves now I think about it. I just have my hands, so like my hands are getting like cut up on the fucking ice. It sucks. But
it's fucking fun. I love ice skating. I haven't done it in like 2 years, but it's really, really fun.
Remember when that...
ice skate, Derek? Yeah, I did. Well, I did only one time in 2004, and it was piece of cake. It was literally like, it was almost no different than rollerblading.
Rollerblading is super really fun. That shit is dope.
It's been a minute. Yeah. It's been a long time since I've... The last time I went rollerblading was like Central Park in 1999. I remember that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's been, you know, 21 years.
I thought about actually buying some. I put up a poll on Twitter, but people preferred me to get a Razor scooter over rollerblades. But I was like, I want to get some 90s shit, dude. I want to start like doing 360s and shit in fucking in South Central. I'm gonna show all these fucking thugs what's good.
I want to get heelys, but they just don't make them in.
You can, they're find not them. I don't know why they're not just in an abundance on Amazon for like adults or some shit.
Dude, I'd be all over them. Look, your Heelys are so fucking fun, man.
Well, it's been a long time since Heelys. I searched. Maybe they finally have them on Amazon now.
Heelys are funny until you hurt yourself, dude. One of our friends in like fucking middle school tried a trick on Heelys, and he hurt himself real bad to the point one of us had to run home and tell his parents.
Well, you're not supposed to be doing tricks.
It's always funny till then. But the commercials show you them doing tricks.
Of course. How else are you going to sell them?
Well, then why would they show you? Like, as a kid, you're going to be like, this can happen. This is possible. I know it's possible. I'm going to try to achieve it. And you try, and then you got to go to a hospital. You don't see him for the rest of the summer.
I'll never forget one summer. I think it was like 2004, 2005, something like that. Is that an adult Heely? Is that what I'm looking at right now?
They're on fucking... They are on fucking Amazon
now.
No
way.
Of course, it's not fucking adjusting to the... Okay, that's even worse. All right, whatever. But yeah, they're on Amazon now. $60, bruh. $60.
$60?
Adults?
I wonder if they have clown size for me.
They have... I think it goes up to... I just saw it. Let's see. What the hell happened to it? Okay. The size goes up to... Oh, that's pretty cool. I like how Amazon's... interface is pretty awesome. Oh, 13. I don't know if you can fuck with that.
I can't get those.
Just bought them. Just bought them.
You got the what is it? The one click thing. You just, all you have to do is push one button.
Yep, just got it.
I hate
that's
you
some,
guys,
that's some
man.
Wally
There's
shit,
so much
dude.
Shit I just can't fucking put on my feet. I hate it. There's so many Jordans that I've tried to buy that I can't fit in. Like, I'm sorry,
dude,
we don't
really?
Have that size.
Wait, do you have...
We're
oh, because you have...
dude.
They don't have, really? They don't have fucking, I thought like.
15s are never at stores, man.
Really?
15,
I mean,
15s
you
never
think
at
fucking store. Jordans.
Is,
you would think
they're
Jordans
just
would
out
like.
Of my range.
Basketball niggas like have big ass feet. You think that they would have 15s, you know?
What happens is that's the 15 like, is the just out of the range of like regular size feet. So it's like for every big motherfucker, they have size 15 feet. It's like every regular size person has size like 10, and every smart person has size like 8. So it's just like off one of those that just go missing.
You want me to grab you a pair of Heelys, my guy?
Nah, dude. No, thank you, man. They don't have my size. That's cool, though. I appreciate it.
Now, come on. Let's Heely. Let's Heely around Los Angeles.
The apartment. The fucking apartment.
I'm really considering fucking getting one.
I hate you guys.
I'm really considering buying. I was like, yo.
Fucking
these look
Heelys.
Dope, too, because they kind of look like Vans.
Yeah, no,
they're,
exactly. Yeah. They're subtle. So, it doesn't have, like, the famous Heelys mascot on them. Or whatever the hell. Do you remember the Heelys mascot, Kingston?
The Heelys mascot?
Yeah.
What was that?
It was Dr. Drew with wheels all over him.
Oh my fucking God. You and your Dr. Drew.
By the way, I forgot to mention this at the top of the show. I can't believe I didn't mention it, but shocking news about Dr. Drew.
Oh yeah?
Yeah,
what happened?
Well, he passed away this morning.
Oh,
okay,
oh,
let me check again to make sure.
I mean, I'm pretty sure I just saw that he was in Baja with his wife.
It's the funeral, yeah.
He had a funeral in Baja? What the fuck?
That's where he was born.
Bury me in Baja.
That'd be a nice place to be buried. That'd be a nice place to be buried.
Oh, my God. Anyway, fuck it. What the fuck are we talking about?
I don't know. Something and then Heelys. I don't even know how the fuck we got there.
We were from the election to consoles to Heelys.
Oh, we're talking about ice skating and shit.
Oh, ice skating. Yeah. Right. Yeah. I don't know how we got onto that either. But
man,
he's not dead yet. Again, he's not dead yet.
All right? Oh, yeah. Stop saying all right, that well, shit. Well, I'm sorry. Like, my sources are usually pretty spot on, so I'm going to have to
Of course.
Some of my sources are you and you're lying about it.
Who are your fucking sources? Who do you talk to? Who you fucking?
It's him.
I can't
he
just give up
himself.
My source. I can't just give up my sources, Derek. Like, that'd be really irresponsible and a breach of journalistic ethics.
Who's it? Ian Miles Chung?
No.
No.
What?
He's great. He does great work, bro.
He does. Honestly, like him and Andy Ngo, like, are some of the some of the voices of our generation.
Oh my God. Isn't that the Texan Japanese guy?
Is he Texan? No, he's like Malaysian.
He's something. Well, the Chong guy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Andy Ngo, I think he's Korean, and he lives in Seattle?
No, he's like Oregon, I think.
I thought he was Seattle. You're right. Because Portland, he does stuff in Portland. That's right.
Isn't he? Aren't those the fucking the whites? What you call it?
What?
The people. I forgot what you're talking. What are you guys talking about? Who are those people?
No. What are you talking about? What did you say?
Yeah. How do you not know these people?
Because I don't care about that stuff.
We're specifically starting a political podcast. Remember, where we're gonna be political pundits. Remember, we talked about
I'm not doing that. I'm not. Don't put me in this. This is not involving me.
What do you mean? We specifically talked about that.
We all agreed.
You brought it up,
played,
man. Don't you remember bringing this idea up, Kingston? Don't you
remember? We all agreed we would play Among Us with AOC and Gaddafi.
Oh my God. Gaddafi? Oh my God. Could you imagine AOC? Could you imagine Barack Obama, Kamala Harris, AOC, Vladimir Putin, fucking that guy that they blew up in fucking Iran. There's a bunch of fucking
Baghdadi?
World leaders playing fucking Among
Us. That would
us.
Be the most honestly, for real, that would be the most distressing game of Among Us in the world because you just see all these world leaders lying through their teeth to each other.
And it's
like
stress-inducing. You're like, ugh.
That is not something that the world is ready for.
I'm not the imposter.
Obama be like, well, look at me. I didn't kill anybody because I don't have any drones, you see? Like, it could
have
been me.
I saw Crooked Hillary... In electrical, and she was standing over Gaddafi. Gaddafi's dead. Explain this.
This is so fucking hilarious.
Jesus fucking
Christ.
I'd be like, listen here, all right? I didn't kill anybody. I don't have time. Medicare.
Gaddafi's dead. Explain this.
He's just is fucking... Wait, he probably doesn't have a coffin. It's probably his corpse is rotting on the back of a fucking truck. And then they just back it up to a computer. They just back it up to a computer. Like, all right, Gaddafi.
On the back of a
Let's
holy
go.
Shit.
Yo, they messed him up.
Dude, they fucked him up so good.
They messed him up. But, fuck, all right. Let's move on to some questions since we're about an hour and 5 minutes in. Now's about the time where we go into... That's about the time where we go into questions anyway. And remember, you can leave a question if you support us over at patreon.com/thesnarktank, my guy. $5 is all it takes to get a question potentially
Five.
Right on the show. And because...
$5 foot long.
Because we're doing... there are some... just to flesh this out a little bit more... there are some solo episodes that I'm planning on doing with like either just me by myself or Derek by himself
solo
or like Sweeney by himself to answer some questions that are like a little bit more hyper specific to each of our interests. Mm-hmm. That, like, because I know, like, there have been many conversations on this podcast about mixing music, and Sweeney just sits there like a dead deer. Yeah. You know,
I don't know how to mix music.
No. I know. And so, like, that's what those solo episodes are going to be for, like, specifically questions that are tailored to our specific shit. So if you asked us a question that was, you know, too specific for the show, chances are they're going to be in the Patreon exclusive solo shows going forward. So don't worry if your shit hasn't been read yet.
Or ask questions about solo shit to give me in episodes as well, guys.
Yo, you see that fucking the animated
dude, that shit had Porctopus? Me in tears.
Yeah,
dude.
The Porctopus. Dude, that was so fucking good. So fucking
those animateds are so goddamn cool and flattering.
They're hilarious. Thank you for those, dude.
Yeah, Porctopus has been fucking hammering those things out, and they're all so
good. Killing it.
Real. He gave me probably, like, my favorite, like, cartoonified version of my own face that I've ever seen. And I just appreciate that shit.
He made me a ball for most of the fucking animated. I was a fucking
He gave you your
circle.
Gerald hair too. I was pretty happy.
Yeah, he gave my flat top a fucking a circle.
You look like season one Will Smith. All right. Som Tweeney's Klesty Samzoss wrote in.
Mm.
He asks, hey there, funky Hispanic and his chocolate dynamic. Would you rather always... That's not a bad name, honestly. Would you rather always be hard and never come, or always be flaccid and constantly be coming? Thanks for the...
Hard and never come. Hard and never come.
Yeah, obviously. That's, like, obviously the answer, right? Like,
if you're flaccid and always coming, you know how much your life is going to be salty?
All the time?
You can't do anything. You can't wear pants. Can't fucking
I mean, you
go
would
out.
Be a niche. You can be a niche porn star.
You would feel. You would feel. I think that at that point you would probably feel like
nothing.
Like hungover all the time. You know,
you'd have to be drinking so much water.
So much water. You probably wouldn't even. Water probably wouldn't even cut it. You would need like special like
Pedialyte.
Extra strength Pedialyte or something just to keep you
like
from
all
draining.
The time.
that's an obvious one, dude. Like, no way in hell am I gonna want to be like fucking soft and spraying, you know?
Could you imagine they'd have to put a tube up inside your pee pee to funnel it all out so you don't then it would fucking fill up a bin of you just coming all fucking day. They'd have to change out the bin like a piss bag. Your life would be ruined.
Your life would be ruined. Always okay, so always being hard would be a bitch also, but it's far more...
It would be extremely annoying.
It would be extremely annoying, but it wouldn't be, like, life-ruining, I feel like.
Yeah. The only annoying part is that I like to sleep on my stomach at some points of the night, so that would be very difficult. And other than that, I used to sleep a lot in high school and shit, and I would get, like, fucking the morning wood or whatever after I'd wake up, and I just would just rock my boners. I didn't care, because... I mean, whatever, dude. Like, what are you gonna do?
What would happen would you be really good at sending dick pics. You always be at full staff, you know.
Yeah.
You always be alert. Yeah. You'd be at full alert. So you'd be like, here's this picture. And they'd be like, whoa, man. It's like, yeah, and it never goes
down. The golden
down.
Hour is.
You'll
every
have
hour.
The best night of your life, but I won't.
God,
that
damn.
Would be. That's a great benefit, actually, because
you would bang bitches out. You'd win. You'd be a fucking game breaker.
Yeah, you wouldn't. Yeah. You couldn't lose. In that scenario,
exactly.
You know,
you see, it's better. It's better overall.
It's better overall. It still sucks. I would rather neither of these, but that is clearly the superior one. So thank you, for that enlightening question.
Amazing.
That's a pretty good one, bro. I appreciate
that. It is a good one. It also cost this person $5.
I'm sure it was well worth it.
He's like, yes, I hope so. Thank you guys. I appreciate it. You told me all.
Oh my
I know
God.
Everything I need to know now.
Let's see.
What's next?
Latino who actually speaks Spanish wrote in. He says, quick question for Derek. Do you remember a stick death animation that was the stick men fighting a squirrel that had huge nuts? Am I crazy or am I the only one who remembers this?
No, I definitely remember that. I absolutely remember that. 100%.
What is that about?
I'm going to look this up now.
The Stick Death was just a stupid fucking website of just animated stick figures. You know, it was just like some Flash bullshit. And they would just die in a bunch of different ways. there was this weird like demon one that would always play like Rob Zombie, and it would just come and terrorize people and rip their faces off and shit.
It was talking about Super Beasts?
Yes. Oh yeah. Yeah.
Holy shit, I know about
this. I saw these. I saw Stick Death like a long time ago, but I don't remember any squirrels. I included this because I was like, there's no way this is real, but apparently I guess he remembers. Fucking wild.
Yeah, let me see if I can pull that up.
Stick Death is so old. That's we were just talking about that, right? Were we talking about that in?
Yeah, we were talking about it at Shoe Stream. We're on her Brainlet channel.
That's right.
Yeah.
I was wondering why the hell this is a throwback.
I remember this when I was a fucking virgin, bro. It's like 10 years ago, dude. It's crazy,
bro. That was back when I had I don't remember if it was Yahoo or whatever. My first email I ever made, I was probably like 10 or 11 years old, was Pimpmaster 3000. And I can't remember the address correctly because I was like, fuck, I want to log into it and see what's on there. Probably a bunch of like AIM notifications and shit that like I just want to jog my memory because those were like the fucking ASL days and shit. ASL, oh bro. God. And I'd be like, I'm fucking 16. I'm 6 feet tall. Some bullshit. I don't remember.
My dick is 15 inches flaccid. What you flaccid. Want, bitch?
Got fucking 9 inches soft. What's good? You want some of that or what?
God damn. That's
nine
a curse.
9 inches soft.
It is a die. Curse, man. I don't know. I personally don't know any women. Every woman I've met that has come encounter with like a massive hog has hated it. Like, I'm talking about, like, you know, I guess hate, it's the that's the wrong word. They're saying, like, it's a bitch to get used to, I guess. Because, I mean, I imagine you fucking have ravaged some women, Sweeney, and they probably
I'm not a freak. I'm not a fucking demon. All
right?
That's
right.
Insane.
This guy's got a fucking, if you have this nigga's got like a Pringles can and shit.
Penis, if you have a nine, look. If I had a 9-inch flaccid penis, my girlfriend would have died by now. She would have fucking passed away because that's not.
Imagine how big it would be. Like, because how many. Dude, I haven't. Here's the thing. I haven't measured, like, when I was, like, a kid, you know, like high school. Not high school. Middle school. Like, how big is my dick? Like, that was, like, the last time. And I'm like, I don't care enough to do it, but at the same time, I'm interested to know, like, an average, and then say fully at like just full mass, how much does it grow, and then so we can extrapolate, like, say an average of 9 inches soft. I guess I can just look it up on the internet, right? Say, oh, how the average, blah blah blah, because this, how big would a fucking would one get if it was 9 inches soft and then be fully erected? Like, how many inches would it grow? That's good. Like, that's. That's so fucking
it'd be,
asinine.
It'd be fucking death. It could, it'd be could, like you see the could, skull over the icon
potentially
of your
not,
penis.
Well, it could potentially not grow at all also. You know, like it could just, you know, because that's a thing.
What, it just like,
just
what does
stiffen
it do?
Up?
That's a thing. That's a thing for some people apparently. Like it just like, it's just the same length, but it just
what?
Gets powered what? On.
Well, they have like blood in their dick like all the time?
No,
like,
I don't know. This is just shit I've heard. I only know my equipment, so like I don't know what the fuck this shit is. But I've heard this before.
Oh my god!
Yeah, that's,
your dick
that's
doesn't grow. It just fucking tones up like fucking like the Rock flexing.
Oh my fucking god! What are we looking for? Alex wrote in. Hello, Yogi Bare Hand Sween, some boxing bussy guy, and Paul's gangly flesh slave. If any of you guys could have an army entirely made up of one specific thing, what would it be? Brown bears, zombies, robots, emus, whatever. Not looking for the most powerful ones, just one you would find useful or fun.
Bastion head trolls, man. Bastion head trolls.
Well, shit, man. Because I was gonna say fucking shot. I was gonna say shot Uncle Ben. I mean, it just goes back. It's like full circle.
I want wasps, man. I want wasps. Always. You couldn't stop a person commanding an army of wasps. It'd be fucking unreal.
Oh, sexually aggressive horses, bro. That'd be perfect.
What'd you say?
Sexually aggressive horses.
Oh my! Why?
That's
Well, I'm tearing down armies, bro.
Who was that guy that got killed? Bursting into homes,
mountain people, fucking killing them. Like, get them all.
Who's that guy that, like, got fucking fucked by a horse to death?
Mr. Hands.
Mr. Smiles, bro. He died.
So literally, you just want to Mr. Hands everybody. Like, with
everybody, bro. You can't stop me.
I don't want to come face to face with just a relaxed horse. You know, like I just don't trust them as animals. They got long heads.
They're just too big. They're intimidating.
I can't with the long head.
Horses are so sweet, dude.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, they also
they're chill. They're just so big. They could kill the shit out of you.
They're so big. They have there's flies like tap dancing around in their fucking eyes, and they don't mind. if there are flies dancing around in my eyes, I feel like I would notice and I would care about it, you know?
Yeah,
and
you
I would
think that, but Obama, Pence, fucking Hillary. Like, it's just, these niggas, they have flies on their all the time and they're just chilling.
Once saw Hillary Clinton walk into a Holiday Inn and a fly burst out of one of her pores. I shit you not.
That would fucking kill me.
Hillary has flies. Actually, it's not even. She doesn't even have hair. That's just a wig.
Hillary is flies.
She's just made up of a bunch of flies. If you want to know the secrets, buy my water filters.
Yo, for real though, like an army of an army of shot Uncle Bens, I don't think would yield you much much results.
I think it would
freak people lying on the floor dying.
Why is this man shimmying on the floor? this man amassed an army of a dying fictional man. Like, that is such a wild fucking metaphysical statement.
Just
that means imagine he has more hearing power like than he even fucking knows.
Imagine hearing like thousands of fucking Sean Uncle Ben saying Peter in unison, just like
Peter.
Like just Peter. Loud,
the
like a
ground
fucking
shakes, dude. The ground shakes.
The ground
as the
shakes.
Fucking waves. And Peter, and you're like, what the fuck? What's happening to me?
You can hear it from the fucking
Peter,
ISS.
They shot me, Peter.
They shot me. Damn dirty niggas fucking shot me good.
Could you imagine, like, You're in like somewhere. Where is it? Where are they not gonna immediately? You're in Florida, right? And you're like, oh, man. Apparently, there's this guy with a bunch of really angry horses coming this way, and all of a sudden, a fucking horse, a wrecked as fuck, breaks in your door and immediately tries to mount you, and you can't outfight a horse. No one I know can. So you're just trying to get it off you, and the horse is fucking horse-legs hitting you in the head, and you're like, God damn, I'm going to die, you know? And then bang, it mounts you. That's it. And that's one body. And he's not done. The horse is not done yet. He's got more to go. So he goes to the next house, and it's only one horse. There's thousands, tens of thousands of horses.
You don't know anybody who can fight off a horse?
No one.
I mean, there's a few rednecks that'll shotgun blast them in the face because
they sleep
with their guns.
Fight off. They can kill horse, but no one's going to is going to fight off a horse.
I mean,
I saw a horse kick a guy in the fucking stomach one time when I was on a farm, and we were at the farm for 3 hours, and when we left, the guy was in the same position on the floor.
Oh my God. You sure he wasn't fucking dead?
I was dead? Yo, I remember we walked in, the horse kicked him, and they were like, kids, look over here, and I was like maybe in third grade, and I was like, oh, wow. And then we left, and he was still like that. And I was like, teacher, why is that man still lying there? And they were like, don't worry about it, kids.
Yeah, he was fucking dead, dude. He got kicked by, like, that is such a, like, a, I can't even imagine being kicked by a horse, man. That's so much power.
I can barely imagine being kicked by, like, a sturdy person. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, a horse is, like, that's
so many pounds of pressure. You're fucked.
They can do shit to you with their legs that, like, magicians, like, real magicians probably couldn't do, you know? Like, sorcerers
real
probably
magicians.
Couldn't do. They could smash your fucking organs like piñatas without breaking your skin. Like, I don't even understand the power that, like, lies behind that fucking leg.
If a horse jumped up in the air and then it came back down on its one of its feet onto your head, one of its hooves, it'd pop your head. Pop your shit like a fucking zit.
One of my favorite fucking gifs on the internet is of that deer I've never watched Adventure Time, so I don't know what I have no idea what the fucking show is. But
I saw the first few seasons, really good.
There's this clip of like a deer jumping on fucking Finn's legs, and it just cracks his leg in like a 90-degree angle, and it's one of the funniest things I've ever seen. But it's always how I imagine any encounter with a deer or like a horse going. It's just like, oh, I'm gonna step on you until you snap. Because deer do that a lot. They do that to fucking dogs. They just like fucking, you know, they just fucking aggressively assault dogs.
They cut you the fuck
dogs.
Up, man.
Huh?
They slash you up, man. They take, while they're doing that, you think it's just their hose, but they actually have a knife in their hands. And they're fucking spinning a knife real fucking fast and they're cutting you. And you don't
fucking notice it.
You see hooves.
You're like, yo, you ever see horses?
You go home, you're like, oh, I'm lacerated. What the fuck is this?
Yo, you ever see a fresh horse?
Like a brand new one with his little toesies?
Like a brand new, like, just born, a fresh ass
horse. Oh, you mean
horse.
Like, that? Is that the term you use when something's born, just born?
Fresh?
Isn't it a fawn?
I don't know. What? A fawn? No, a fawn's like a...
No, that's like a deer thing.
Yeah, that's like a deer or like an elk or something.
What's a baby horse called? Let me Google it.
A baby horse is called a fucking horse.
It's, yeah, horsey. I don't
know. Horsey?
It's called a horsey.
No, but I just mean like... But like fresh, that term, that was the thing that threw me off. That like is something when it's just born.
It's a foal. I was close.
Oh, a foal. Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I've heard that before.
So have you ever seen one of those?
No.
So their fucking hooves, man, are tentacles.
Oh yeah, I have seen that. Okay, yeah.
You've probably seen it because I tweeted it once.
Is that always true, or is it sometimes?
Afterwards. Yeah.
Is it sometimes or is it always?
What are you saying? What are you asking?
Like, do they always have tendrils, or is it like?
I think they develop afterwards. so they don't fuck up their the mom's uterus with the fucking hooves.
Yeah.
Oh my god! It's always, that's disgusting.
It's amazing how they evolved that fail safe
until this moment.
Yeah, no, they're basically octopuses.
Yeah, I mean they're not.
What's the difference?
Like
what's honestly the difference between a horse and an octopus if they both have tendrils? You know.
I mean, octopuses fucking learn fast.
They basically
kill themselves on purpose.
99.9% same DNA.
Now octopus, that's an army. That's an army. Like if I could have an army of octopi, that's a whole nother fucking realm.
They move really slow though on land.
Yes,
they're really smart, so they probably just leave. They'd be like, "What? I don't want to be here," and they just fucking leave.
They probably do what we do and fucking abandon army. One will be like, yo, guys, I don't want to do this. I'm leaving tonight. And he's like, dude, don't leave. You're going to go AWOL. He's like, I don't give a fuck. I'm out of here. I'm going to become a fucking singer. He fucking leaves.
I'll become a singer.
Do octopi, is it squids or octopuses that or octopi that have beaks? Or both?
Squids have the beaks.
I think both.
Well, I guess they both do have their beaking mouths, right?
They both have beaks.
I'm curious.
Squids just have, like, fucking hooks and shit.
Hooks?
Squids are just disgusting. They look like dickheads.
Yeah. Squids have, like hooks... with their suctions and shit, they're more
so disgusting.
And then,
fuck squids!
Oh
man.
Yeah, they do have fucking beaks.
People
That's
are
wild.
Fucking dude. People that you see some people that eat live squid, and people have actually died because they're so fucking stupid that their suctions get stuck in the throats and they suffocate. And it's just like you deserve that so much. Like you absolutely deserve that, like, to be that stupid. Like, they're like fucking, oh, it's the rawest thing, and they just literally start chomping on animals, and they're alive.
Those people are insane. Like, full stop.
It really
that shit is fucking evil. Like, I don't fucking like seafood. Like, I would gas every octopus on the planet. Like, I have no problem.
That's such a weird animal to hate.
They're fucking terrifying. Cool. Like,
well,
they look like nightmares.
He doesn't like aliens. He doesn't like aliens, and they're essentially alien.
I guess.
Yeah, they're and, fucking octopi are fucking like aliens, dude.
And the fact that people eat them while they're alive is still fucking harsh to me. Like I even the think that's harsh, and I'm racist to them. It's like, dang, that's a little much.
How do you feel about Squidward?
I'm happy he's always going through misfortune. It makes me happy seeing him go through bad shit. He deserves it. He's a piece of shit.
I don't like that at all.
Squidward, and fuck you.
Squidward just wants to fucking chill, dude. And then fucking SpongeBob and Patrick just fuck with him all the time. It's unfair.
I wish we could sell that shirt. I wish we could sell that shirt. Fuck Squidward and fuck you.
I mean, we could.
Could you sell? Can you sell something with a SpongeBob name on it?
But it can't have anything to do with Squidward on it.
You can draw something that's like not Squidward. You know what I mean? It's like implied, but it's not him.
Fuck Squidward and fuck you is such a good. It's such
you
a
make
good
Triangle Bob. You make Triangle Bob. You make Patrick Circle. You make Squidward.
Triangle
he's a
Bob.
Actual squid.
Patrick, Bob. What? Instead of a star, what is he? It's
Patrick Circle.
Urchant? He's just. Oh, Patrick Circle. You said that right. Yeah.
Well, it's just. It is still Patrick Star, but it's just like. It's a more photorealistic.
It's like a realistic star where it's just like a blur.
Yeah, it's a big, like
it's
a big ball.
Corona and all that shit in a fucking dark spot. That'd be good.
It would be good.
We should do that, man. We got more ideas, man. More merch coming fucking soon. I swear to God.
Yeah, well, let's hold off on that.
Well, yeah, we haven't more merch. We haven't gotten fucking shit, man.
Yeah, we gotta get some fucking merch up in here. Bastard Son wrote in. Said, hey, yo, take my $25. How do you unholy trio feel about the potential existence of the supernatural or related things like ghosts, Bigfoot, aliens? I like that he mentioned Bigfoot. Just things that may exist. Bigfoot may exist, my guy. but no one can really prove. How would you react in the face of one of these probably made-up creatures? Listen.
I don't got time.
What do you mean you don't have time?
I don't got time.
If someone
that.
Showed you a ghost, like a real, like if someone was like, "Listen, you're not going to believe this, but I have it," and they pull out
a
fucking, they pull out like a fucking, I don't even know, like a butt ugly Martian's.
Jar?
They put out a butt, they pull out a butt ugly Martian's lunchbox, and out comes a fucking ghost, like a real ass godforsaken ghost, and you see it, and you, it's obvious. What is your response to that?
I gotta go, man. I don't got time for this. I get up and I leave.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, that's a
no. I would. Well, my mind
like,
would be changed.
I was like, "Yo, dude, I can't do this. I can't do this right now. I can't. I can't
I would have
accept
to believe
that there's
it.
A ghost in front of me.
I would have to believe
I'd
it
have
because
to leave.
If I didn't, I would have to believe that that's real. Then because if I didn't, then that would mean I'm insane. You know, like that would mean that I've lost all connections with reality because I'm seeing a fucking ghost that is 100% real to me."
But, like, a ghost is, like, the only thing of the other things that he mentioned that are really, that would be, like, what the fuck is this? Because Bigfoot is just, like, a man ape. Okay.
Yeah,
Bigfoot
existing
before.
Yeah, Bigfoot existing isn't really that insane.
Now,
like,
aliens.
Scary.
Aliens, yeah. To me, it's, like, how do you even prove that it's an alien unless it, like, oh, here's my air, my flying saucer or whatever I came from fucking, you know, I'm intergalactic and shit. Because it could just be an animal that we just didn't discover and we think it's an alien or something. So I wouldn't even be, because we've all seen some shit in nature on documentaries or whatever. Like, what the fuck is that thing? Or it might as well be an alien.
Yeah.
So
anything that comes out the water, I'm like, what the fuck? Every time I see something from the deep part of the ocean, I'm like, how the fuck has that been here?
They are all
that's just been here.
Disgusting. In fairness,
I don't know.
There's
a
so
ghost
much
would fuck with me because, like, I don't know. I kind of believe in shit like that. I've also had so many weird occurrences with like fuck shit that doesn't make sense. That would like help part of my brain come to rest, but then the totality of my brain would be like, there's so much more shit that exists that I can't even begin to tackle. I can barely do my taxes. I can barely fucking pass my classes. Now this shit is here. Like, what the fuck am I gonna do now? There's fucking ghosts.
Yeah, I mean. Yeah, we've had our fair share of weird experiences. Do you remember when we all came home that one day and your room was covered in blood and it said, "It helped me," was written all over the walls in blood and no one was home all day? That was pretty wild, right?
Yeah, that's just not my problem, dude.
I mean, you had to clean it up.
Like, whatever. Whatever. Like, whatever, man. That's fine.
Yeah,
I would just go to bed in the room. I wouldn't even trip. I wouldn't even like act like anything's weird is going on. I'm like, all right, guys, I'm going to sleep, and I would just go to sleep in the
just
room.
Go to sleep
that's
with
it.
All the blood that's just there.
Like, all right, guys, I'm going
fucking,
to bed. That's it.
All right, fucking JoJo wrote in, spelled exactly like Bizarre Adventures. He says,
JoJo.
"Hello, Tom Sweeney and his two groupies, I guess." Nice. I'll be getting into content creation in the very near future, and something I've noticed is that a handful of creators, such as Chris Sween and a few others, don't mind sharing their full government name with their audience. That's a weird way of describing it, like a full government name.
What's your government?
I understand it. It's just like I've never heard it described that way. their full government name with their audience, while most creators guard that information very closely. What's your guys' take on people knowing your names, and what advice do you give? I don't know if I have any advice, but like, well, I know
if
I have
you don't
takes.
Want it, don't share.
I definitely have advice. The advice is, if you have something to lose and you're going to do controversial stuff, then maybe you want to be anonymous. Other than that, it doesn't fucking matter because, and this is me being 100% honest, nobody gives a fuck about you. Like, you're not, like, if you're just making nice stuff or whatever, you know, nobody's going to fucking search and SWAT you and all this shit unless you're just a complete cunt and you're surrounded by a bunch of people like that. So, like, I have a stage name, right? But I don't care that, you know, I've showed, like, my real name on Facebook posts and whatever, and posted on Twitter or something like that.
Yeah.
And people are like, oh, I thought your last name was Blackman. Like, I'm like, no, it's just, that's just a, you know, if you search that, that's where all my, you know, art is, I guess. But it doesn't matter, like, unless you did some shady shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, exactly. I kind of agree. I think I
have nothing to worry about.
I had YouTube for so long, and my channel has, I don't know, I never made my identity a secret. So even when I was like cognizant, like when I started to be cognizant of like, oh, it might be a good idea to be anonymous, it was already too late. So I just didn't really care if my name was out there. But in my experience, based on like how YouTube has evolved and based on like all the content creators that I know and who are on both sides of the aisle with this, I have noticed that the more secretive people are with their personal information, and I mean personal information that's like, you know, kind of generic, like their name or like just the city or state that they live in, the more secretive people are with that information, the more people care about it.
Yes.
And the more people are curious about it, and the more people will try to seek that information out. Whereas if I'm just like, hey, yeah, my name's Chris Ray Maldonado. I live in Los Angeles. You know, nobody gives a shit. Post a picture. I can post a picture like, you know, in town, and no one's going to like, you know, do some forensics on the sky and like try and find me like a He Will Not Divide Us flag, because they know that hilarious. I'm just being real with people. And I'm like, yeah, you know, I live in Los Angeles and that's fine. But the people who like are really secretive, the people who are like, I am, I don't know, Ex Machina 23 or whatever the fuck, and, you know, I don't take pictures outside because I don't want anybody recognizing the, you know, the fucking skyline or whatever the fuck. They're the people who I see a lot of, like, threads about on, like, like Lolcow or, like, some
mysterious.
Other... Mysterious. Yeah, like, some other, like, random forums of, like, hey, I recognize this, and, like, it's crazy shit. But that's just my... In my experience, it's like the more prohibited something is, the more people want to know it. So yeah. I've just been pretty upfront. It's like, yeah, you know, this is my name. This is where I live vaguely, you know, like, and whatever.
That for you. It makes sense.
A big deal.
Yeah. I still wouldn't like post a picture in front of my building, you know, but like,
oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's stupid.
There's limits. You don't.
Yeah, there's obvious things online. That are just like for basic security that you wouldn't say. But for the most part, like, I don't know. I don't think either one is necessarily better than the other. I think everybody has a reason for doing what they do and hiding the information that they hide or disclosing the information that they disclose. But
it's their choice.
But yeah, in my experience, that is definitely a dynamic to pay attention to.
Yeah. I'll just say, if you don't have to, don't fucking do it. That's all I say. Like, if you don't have to, what the fuck's the point? That's just kind of how I feel about it. Or it's just an extra step for what reason. But, you know, if you have to, like, say, I know some creators that are secular in an Islamic state, and they have to be anonymous because they'll get fucking killed if they're found out, like, as being an apostate. Wait, apostate?
Yeah, apostate, yeah.
Yeah, I was apostate. Like, apostle? What the fuck? What am I thinking? Anyway, yeah, so things like that make sense, but... If you don't have a reason, you're going out of your way just to for fucking no reason.
Agreed.
Let people know you and post your address and give me your social security card. Let me see.
Give me your credit card information, please.
And give me all your information. Three digits on the back. I'd appreciate it.
Exactly. I'm trying to buy shit with your money.
Yeah, I'm trying to get. I will get the consoles. I'll get the new consoles if one of y'all fucking give me your credit card information.
Facts. Quickly. Quickly. When are they going to stock back with the consoles, man? I just want my PS5. Oh, fuck. I'm so annoyed.
You just
got to
deal with it.
The idea that. Look, it. This is. Isn't this shit criminal to you guys? It's obviously not literally criminal, but the fact that they're doing this bullshit and not. There's not gonna be a surplus. Why are they not fucking stocked up the ass? Like, there's not gonna be a surplus of like, oh fuck, we didn't sell all of them. What are we gonna do? We gotta mark them down. Like, that's not gonna happen. Yeah.
Well, I bet. I'm sure COVID fucked with the supply constraints. Yeah. I'm sure that had a lot to do with it. Because there's no reason why they wouldn't want to sell as many as possible. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that is their main goal, but. You know, also shipping, like, this is mostly, like, Amazon and, like, retailers' fault for, like, fucking either selling more than they had in stock or, you know, not ordering enough to fulfill the orders that they sold. So I don't necessarily put the blame on, like, Microsoft or Sony for, like, not making enough. They clearly, because they have every incentive to make as many as possible.
Yeah,
because they don't want to sell softer than the last generation. They want to have as many people... paying for their services as possible, so their incentives are very clear. But it's obvious that this year was just fucked.
Because was there any shortages for so PS4 and
no,
Xbox
there
One?
Were no. Not that I remember. I'm sure there were, but like it wasn't like this where like oh you don't know when you're gonna get yours. It's usually like oh you didn't get it. If you didn't get it that week, you'd have to just wait for the restock, you know, and the restock wouldn't be that much further off. It would be like maybe like within the week or like maybe next week or something. It'd be pretty fucking quick. The last time this happened with a console, it was the Nintendo Wii, because those things were flying off the shelves. But even those were created, you know, there was artificial constraints with that to make the Wii on Nintendo's part to make the Wii seem more in demand than it was, which made it more in demand.
That makes sense.
I mean, that thing was $200. Like, I mean, that thing was flying off the fucking shelves. Like, I had two of them, and I played a total of like three to 4 hours of Wii. You know, barely anything.
I bought one like late. Like, I bought one like right before I moved to California, dude.
You couldn't find them for a while, man. Like, it's very similar to the situation. Maybe even worse back then. I just hope
I get it eventually. I don't want to have to wait till fucking the next year to have a PS5. That'd make me really upset.
Don't fucking worry. Just keep your order.
Just
don't be like, oh, I didn't get it fast enough, so I'm going to cancel my order. Because then
I'm not doing that.
Gone.
I'm doing that whenever I get it, I get it. If I can get a chance to get one sooner than getting it from GameStop, I'm going to do that. But
you could have took
until then, I'm holding off of GameStop.
Yeah, a lot of times it's actually easier to like just get them from like fucking retail stores like Target and shit.
Retail stores are selling out, dude.
No, they do, but then they don't. It's a weird. There's a wave that happens where everyone's like, "Fuck, nothing's gonna be there," and then they show up, and because they're fully stocked, and now people aren't fucking like coming out in droves. It's like a weird thing where that's how I got like say what do you call it? I mean, I know it wasn't insane, but at the same time, what was it, the Switch? Like that, where that was a kind of people were selling out everywhere and this and that, and I went to Best Buy and they fucking, I'm like, oh, they got a couple over here. What the fuck? There you go.
The Switch 4, as in demand as that machine was pretty abundant when it came out. Like I got mine day of release, no problem.
They did
it was
a pretty
fine.
Decent job then, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah. PS4 Pro was the same. Like, so it's just this year has just been like so fucked.
Yeah.
Really sucks. Well, really sucks for the people who really wanted one, because then and who didn't manage to get a pre-order, and you know, because if you got a pre-order and it's late, then you still have at least one that's got your name on it. But like,
that's true.
The people who got screwed over, like, and there are people there are a bunch of like Keemstars out there,
online,
a bunch of Keemstars out there buying like 200 of them and scalping them probably. Yeah.
Keem bought 200.
No, I'm just joking. But like, he did record a Twitter video of him like standing in a room full of PS5s. So it wouldn't surprise me if he was just like. Stockpiling a bunch of them to scalp
because that is
the kind of person that he is.
It's pretty stupid.
All right, what do we got here? Pepperoni wrote in. He says, "What's poppin', you three beautiful amalgamations of meat and fluids? Halloween season is finally is officially over, and thus Christmas is now going to be forcefully shoved down our throats for the next 2 months. I am wondering what you guys generally think of the Christmas season, love it or hate it. That might be too broad. So an easier question would be something along the lines of, what's the best gift you've ever received? No, it's, I think it's it wasn't too broad. I think it's totally fine.
I hate Christmas, personally. I fucking hate it.
You hate Christmas?
I hate it, but I love... I hate Christmas because of how much money I spend every year in Christmas. Like, no matter how much money I have, like, I have more money than I usually have this Christmas, and it's still going to be fucking gone. I know it. I know it's just going to disappear still. But, like, I hate how much money it is, and I hate... How, like, I love, she's gonna listen to this, she's gonna be so mad. I love my girlfriend, but I hate how she has such a huge, immediate family, and I get them presents. I get all of them presents, and that shit hurts.
You should get them one present that they can share, like a calendar.
Like a cat. Get them an calendar. Expense, bro. I hate it, dude.
I never minded Christmas. I think Christmas is totally fine. Like, I don't love it necessarily. I used to like it when I was a kid. Obviously, every kid likes Christmas for every reason that you could possibly like any holiday. It's like, oh, you get a lot of time off and you get toys. Sick. Yeah, of course. Yeah. Of course, I'm gonna love that. And you get snow sometimes. Sick. But you know, like, I don't know. Like, when you're older, it's like Christmas is. I don't look forward to Christmas, but it's I'm not offended by its presence. The only thing that bothers me is what he opened up the question with, which is the fact that the second Halloween ends, it just becomes that time.
Immediately
but
Christmas, yeah.
It's just immediately Christmas, but this is probably the only upside to this pandemic. Because I'm not just walking around in retail stores now, and because no one's really going out and everything's kind of fucked, I haven't seen much Christmas anything.
Yeah.
Already. And it's like, it's November 16th. It's unusually late in November for me not to have any Christmas things, but I haven't. I haven't seen any decorations. I think I heard maybe one Christmas song playing over.
I haven't heard any.
Like,
it's
playing,
fantastic.
Playing over like the loudspeaker when I was walking through a mall to get somewhere. But it's probably the most restraint I've ever seen in my lifetime of, like, a Christmas season that's just kind of holding off until, you know, when it's probably a little bit more appropriate.
It's angelic. It's fantastic. Fuck Christmas.
It is pretty nice. Fuck Christmas.
Yeah, it's whatever. I just, the weather's nice. I like wearing hoodies and stuff, so. But I'm not really, I've never been a fan of the whole gifting thing. Like I don't like feeling obligated to get anybody anything. It's
I don't like that, but I also don't like other people feeling like they're obligated to get me things. That's kind of what I hate more than the feeling, because I don't know, like, usually I only feel like I have to get somebody something if they get me something, and that's kind of why I just don't want to be given anything. I just, because I'm so bad at shopping for other people. I barely know what I want, you know, like, all I know is that, like, I want the things that I need for, like, my job. So, like, yeah, I want a PlayStation so I can cover stuff for the PlayStation podcast. Oh, I want, like, a new SD card so I can save all my old files, but also, like, have a new card so that I can fill it with new shit. Oh, I want, like, I don't know, like, a better mouse or just shit that's, like, really, like, work oriented. So, like, whenever somebody's like, "Oh, hey, it's Christmas. What are you gonna get so and so?" I'm like,
I've been given so many terrible gifts in my life that I'm just like, don't get me anything. Just give me money if you're gonna give me something, or just don't give me.
Yo,
anything.
Honestly, socks
like,
and underwear.
I hate bad gifts.
Socks and underwear, man. Fucking great. Fucking that's
fantastic.
If you have to give me something, socks and underwear will do me just fucking fine.
Give me some fucking boxer briefs, 100%.
Give me some boxer briefs. Give me some fucking socks. That's something that I used to hate as a fucking kid, but now it's like, oh my god, it's a godsend.
Because
by the time here's the thing, every Christmas I get a bunch of socks, and then by December of the following year, by December 1st, none of the socks match. I've lost like half of them. It's all fucked. So, like, just replenish my socks, and that's as much as I need.
Replenish.
Replenish.
Replenish
that's
me.
That's pretty. That's actually pretty.
Replenish my socks.
The only thing I do
please.
For Christmas is I get myself something. I get myself one little thing that's not even necessarily, like, super expensive. I got myself a jacket, like, the other day, and that was it. Because I was like, I want a bomber jacket. I haven't had a bomber jacket for a while, so I got myself a bomber jacket. Fuck it. You know? And that was it. That was, like, $65. and I'm set.
That's it for me. I get what I want.
And now you got some Heelys, boy.
That's true. I did impulse buy the Heelys.
Gonna be rolling around with that bomber jacket.
Gonna look fly as fuck. Gonna like a fly guy from the 70s.
Dude, man, I love it. I love having a bomber jacket, man. I'm probably gonna try and fit those Heelys into a video, cause I'm excited.
You gotta do some tricks on that, man. You gotta grind some shit.
Yo, dude, trust me, it's gonna end badly, bro. Trust.
What if I come back looking like a pretzel? Like I go out and I'm like, hey, sweetie, I'm gonna go do some tricks on my Heelys, and then some guy wheels me up the stairs in a wheelbarrow, and
a wheelbarrow.
A wheelbarrow, and then it's like, "Hey, is this your roommate?" And it's like, "Ah, yeah."
Like, no, I'm not fucking like, roommate. Oh, dude, get out of here.
That's fucked up.
Oh my god, have a heart.
Hey, have man. A fucking heart.
Hey man, you know what this is?
What do we got? We got time for probably one more of these. Let's see. What do we got?
Let's see what else we got. Peter, they beat me, they stabbed me.
Aram 22, or Aram 22? I don't know.
Aram? I don't know what that is. What is that?
Aram?
I don't know. But he wrote in, he says, hey there, Adobo, Paprika, and Iru? Iru?
I don't know.
Iru?
I don't know.
IRU. I've never heard of that. I'm actually curious as to what that is. I know what Adobo and Paprika is.
I'm looking it up.
What the fuck is Iru? Iru?
It must be a spice.
Yeah, but
it
like
it must be a spice, but what the fuck is it?
Yeah, what's
who the fuck's spice? Paprika?
What's paprika? Never heard of that in my fucking life.
What the fuck? It's a type of fermented and processed locust beans. I don't even know what the hell that means, but I don't. Anyway, let's say hypothetically, for the sake of argument, you're a lady who despises performing fellatio, and your man offers to change the taste of his baby batter to anything you'd like. What would you choose? And don't pussy out with any of your highfalutin Hollywood elite words and logic. Love the podcast. Keep it up.
Gushers.
That's pretty good, but dude, I think that would get old pretty fucking quick, gushers. Though, man.
That's a good answer.
I've thought about this way more than once. Gushers.
You've thought about this?
Shut up. Don't judge me.
I don't think I've ever thought about anything like this in my fucking life.
I mean, so I think to just to like, so it's not too, because that to me, I feel like that would, because how many gushers can you eat? You know what I mean? I feel like after a while, people would be like, okay, I'm over the gushers.
Dude, no one's coming like fucking. I can eat at least 2 packs of gushers, right? No one's coming the equivalent of like 4 or 5 packs of gushers at one time down my throat. So maybe I'm maybe gonna get 4 gushers out of that, you know? Maybe the taste of 4 full gushers and I'm gone, you know? Like that's it.
Yeah. Gushers isn't a bad answer at all. That's I mean, probably that's, the man, gotta be quick. Honestly, that's probably the right answer, you know?
Yeah, I mean, look, I don't have gushers, but I have those, what are those fucking, god damn it, of course I threw them away. Oh, no, I didn't. Here we go.
What is this?
Welch's fruit snacks, man. These fucking
those
things.
Those up there.
It's basically, they're pretty similar. And
those are like hospital gushers.
Those are like hospital
gushers. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's real gushers. Fruit in them. There's real fruit in them, so, you know, it's good for you. I would probably have to say, just to keep with the theme of my seed, I would just probably have it be a vanilla almond milk with reduced sugar. So it's just, like, fucking probably 80 calories per fucking shot or something like that. So that'd be pretty good. I think that would be, I think it would be consistent. It would you could add it to your cereal.
Yeah,
you know, I think.
God Christ!
I mean, you know, it's
oh
just.
Oh my god!
It's a good balance. Whatever you fucking child with your gushers, fuck you.
I think I'm gonna go with Hershey's cookies and cream. It's a good flavor.
Is that chocolate bar?
It's a good taste, man.
It's a good flavor, but like it's like one of those flavors that like gets pretty overpowering when there's like when it's like a whole bar. You know what I mean? But it's never going to be a whole bar if it's just fucking, you know, one load, you know? It's always going to be like maybe like maybe like two, maybe like, you know how Hershey bars have like the rectangles, the
triples.
It might be like three of those rectangles, maybe three and a half. You know,
yeah, that's tolerable. Which
I'm coming like one pack of Gushers, maybe two on a day. I've been really pent up, not doing anything.
Yeah, yeah. I know what you mean.
Yeah,
but
I was thinking about Reese's peanut butter cups, but like I just, it's such a good flavor, but I just really just want to stick with something more subtle. Like where not like,
I feel you.
You know what I mean? Where it's like, oh, this is tasty. This is good. I want some Special K now.
You know, yeah, yeah. You don't want like anything that overstates itself. Yeah.
I want some Special K after my fucking husband jizzed down my throat. I could go for some Special K.
Oh my God. All right. Well, I think that's going to be it.
Ridiculous.
What we're about done.
About
thanks.
How far are we?
Yeah, I think so, right? That's a
pretty good idea. Yeah. We're.
Those are all the questions that I had selected basically. Mm-hmm. I thought we had like two more, but we actually got through all of them. So thank you guys for stopping by for another episode of the Snark Tank podcast. Remember, there is a bit of a scheduling change that you should be privy to. You know, we'll be doing Tuesdays on Patreon and Fridays on free feeds. Keep that in mind going forward. And, you know, we thank you guys for all your support. If you liked what you heard today. Oh, also go to, what is it? What's the merch? SnarkTankMerch.com. We got some merch up there. I'm actually nice. Talking to some people to get more stuff out there. I'm going to be doing some hoodies, some more colors for the hoodies tomorrow morning. So that'll be,
pink,
by the time you hear this then.
And black, all black.
All black. The design will be bright black pink. Too, so you won't barely even see it.
Dude, I had a shirt with a black design on it one time. It was hilarious. It was a Batman shirt with a black, like, glossy Batman design on it. And I was like, this is a waste of money.
Hey, I like so, I have a black.
It's really stupid.
I have a black on black hat. I like it. Shut up.
Anyway, if you liked what you heard today, consider supporting us over at patreon.com/thesnarktank. $1 a month gets you early access. $5 gets you a question read on the show. $10 gets you access to our Discord server. And $25 gets your name dyslexically read at the end of the show, which I will now do.
3, 2, 1.
Bastard son, every time Chris says crazy, how did we even get here podcast? Leroy Jenkins, Master Chief's armor locked cock, Matthew Barrett Clark, Hard Hat Skydiver, Jessica Paris, Absolute Wagon, the army of 101 bananas shoving themselves down Chris's throat. Jesus fuck.
Oh,
all
God.
New, all different. Mario Judah is the whitest Sweeney has ever sounded. Tyler Durden, Monkey Monk, Billy the Big Ball Brawler, A Little Late Term Abortion with Lily Singh, Alaskan Oilfield Trash, Chris Would Be a Twink If He Cared About Hygiene, I Wish My Dad Kissed Me Like Tom Brady, Lieutenant Lipton's Famous Teabag Facials, Not an FBI Agent, Juan Punchman, Marcus Shorten, Mr. What the Fuck Have You Been Listening To, Abusi, Papa Nurgle, Som Tweeney's Klesty's Samzoss. Oh my fucking God. President Joe Budden and Camel Toe Hairzits. Fuck, that's Joe a stretch, Budden. My guy. Game Controller 25, Danny DeVito's Spooky Lovecraftian Draconian Dickbone, Cujo FD, Sweeney's Weenie Sleevey.
Oh my God. Ew.
Murder Ascended, David Connolly, the dyslexic that feels Chris's pain, Dunderhead, JFK's Convertibles, deals so great your head will explode, lobotomized Jesus is my drooling divine savior, Heiko, 1 meter long fetus, Moto Zealot, Mike Tyson's left hook, Gwalar, Hiroshima Spicy Mushrooms, Horrible Henry Hitlerland, the horny Hamtaro Hentai Hoarder, okay. A level 1 cleric, holy shit.
Whoa.
A level 1 cleric, Derek's Unyielding Sex Drive, Dummy Thick Dave, Simp on right. Head, Big Dude 0444, Heartless Wretch, a.k.a. the Black Man from Staten Island, Page 2, Dobby's Freedom Cemented in Semen, Yummy 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 Come Inside My Tummy, The Ghost That Lived in the Apartment Above Chris and Sweeney, Jolly Old Dipshit, Emperor Palpatine, Hugger Derek, The Tom DeLong Stan, Carson Jones, okay. Keith, I Found My Weekly Gimmick, Therian David, The Progerian Hunter, Deflated Left Ass Cheek, America Wars, Episode 2, The Colonial Wars, Anani's Moose, Sonny Chance, Toby Shootman, Artie the One Man Party, parentheses, please love me, Melvis One, El Q Lebron, Richter 86, and the ever present and ever supportive King of Haphazard.
That's right.
We appreciate you all.
Woo! What a list.
And hopefully this goes well. We're doing video for the first time.
Yeah,
so
it's trippy.
Let us know. Yeah, give us your feedback. This is definitely something that we're trying to figure out as we go. I'm definitely going to be stylizing these a little bit more in the future, trying to get some maybe a little bit more custom backgrounds in, maybe fucking around with how we display this stuff. So none of this is set in stone necessarily. I just kind of wanted to get this out and just do it so we could figure things out as opposed to just kind of waiting until we had everything, you know, theoretically perfect and ready to go, and then something would go wrong. And, well, this is already really bad. So I'll see you guys real soon. We'll see you guys real soon.
Bye.
Just trying.
Take care. My tongue
game
we
crazy,
love
son.
You. What up? What up?
What up, nyugga?
You can't fuck with me, bitch. You see these guns?